as part of the plan, detailed investigations were carried out. Here is the plane table survey. It gave us the perimeter as 1 kilometer, an area of 15 acres or say 60,000 square meters, a depth of 2.5 meters at the deepest, and it also contained an island which had an area of 1 acre. The groundwater was tested from nearby borewells and it showed very good water quality. Several permeability tests were carried out, and in three investigative bores, even the soil profile was arrived at. This showed that the bed soil upper layers were quite porous. They consisted of sandy silt, clay silt, and gravelly soils, and the lake therefore could not retain water for long without regular supply. Together with evaporation losses, percolation losses, and rainfall data, we were able to arrive at a hydrological model which showed the daily and monthly requirement of water. Experience confirmed what the investigation showed, and in the monsoon season, rainwater proved insufficient to fill the lake, and the dry bed of the lake was exposed by October itself. Once it became clear that rainwater would not suffice to sustain the lake, other sources had to be considered. The project was being carried out by Southwest Division of DDA, headed by Sri R. K. Sood, Superintending Engineer. They too were enthused by the unusual nature of the Pioneer project. Mr. Sood suggested that the treated effluent of Vasankunj STP be used as a regular source. Thus, the plan had to be adjusted to the prevailing conditions. Whilst rainfall runoff in the catchment would flow to the lake, the regular water supply would consist of the secondary level treated effluent of Vasankunj STP. To further upgrade the treated effluent, it was proposed to introduce duckweed treatment in check dams in the Sanjay 1 reserve forest. For this, a bucket load of duckweed was transported from Badkal Lake and was propagated in small tanks in Sanjay 1 and then introduced into the lagoon of the central check dam. The treated water then flowed through NCERT and IIT campuses, but once in the Rose Garden across Ring Road, the flow was once again in the open and subject to contamination from RK Puram site. Isolating the clean water required laying a 800 meter long pipeline. As this was not budgeted for, we were in a fix. However, Mr. Sood again came to the rescue by utilizing long unused pipe stock in the DDA East Division. Once the water started flowing to the Hauz, it took about 3 months before it could be filled. Subsequently, grass carp fish was brought in from Calcutta. The fish used to come by Kalka mail overnight in oxygenated canisters. From the fisheries department at Seelampur, guppy fish was obtained. Thus, a total of 180,000 fingerlings were introduced into the lake.
As soon as the lake was full of water, biodiversity started thriving in. A large number of resident and migratory birds, such as common coot from Himalayas, northern shoveler from Central Asia, mullet from Siberia, and poachers from northern and central Europe started arriving in winter. resident bird such as spot-billed duck found a new revived habitat. Presence of pond heron, egret, white-breasted kingfisher and cormorant indicated a sign of fish life. Moreover, the catfish has found its way to the lake with the monsoon overflow from Sanjeevan. The lake is thus an aquatic habitat which brings nature to the doorstep of urbanites.
It's a matter of great satisfaction that in 13 years, an estimated 1500 million liters of groundwater recharge has taken place. This is more than almost all the other recharge structures in the city put together. The groundwater quality too was kept under observation, and it is a matter of satisfaction to say that the groundwater can, with minimal treatment, be of potable quality. This is not all. The lake is a carbon sink, capturing carbon dioxide from its airshed. It also has a cooling effect on the surrounding areas. And lastly, it is a stress buster, with its water sheet having a calming effect on frayed nerves. Aerators were introduced to maintain the water quality, but mostly they were not in working order. Once INTACH left the scene, the duckweed blankets in Sanjeevan quickly disappeared, resulting in qualitatively poor inflow. Catfish, which was introduced in the Sanjeevan lagoons by some wayward residents of Mehroli, floated into the Hauz. This carnivorous creature reduced the population of carp and guppies. At this stage, INTACH was recalled, and we introduced the technology of bacterial bioremediation to the lake. The bioremediation process consists of introducing bacterial consortiums, which outcompete the algae for food. This results in reduction of algal turbidity, and the transparent waters then allow sunlight penetration to the bed of the lake. Plants in the lake bed are enabled to do photosynthesis, and the oxygen production enables several microorganisms to survive and play their role in maintaining nutrient balance and thus healthy waters. This pioneer work, accomplished from 2004 to 2007, demonstrated several principles well ahead of time. It is now well established that using recycled water input is the only way to maintain urban lakes. It is also established that the lake bed is the best route to aquifer recharge in the city, and that recycled water offers 365 days of recharging depleted aquifers, as against rainwater recharge, which has become occasional and erratic. It is also known that the recharge water has been purified as a result of soil filtration. Recycled water, once extracted through tube wells, loses the stigma of sewage water, and this is the only way that recycled water can be popularized in this city.
In future, when people will visit this lake, all these efforts will have been forgotten. But the fragrance of the environmental asset will continue lingering.